Time's running out on the expedited grind for Black Ops Cold War as the double-double week is coming to a close here on the 30th. So that means that you should definitely jump on, at the very least, grind out some weapons that you don't really want to sit through at their normal rates, which is what we're going to be talking about here today. We discussed during the launch week some of the best ways to rank up weapons, but I'm going to be honest with you, there's a few revisions that have been since made on how to make that better and that I think that are at least a little bit more enjoyable overall, now after 2 weeks or so since launch. So today we're going to be talking about the ways to maximize your XP yield the most here while there's still some double XP remaining. So that said, let me know your thoughts below. How have you been grinding through these weapons this past week? What weapons have you completed, if any at all? And are there any that you're just not looking forward to using? Whatever it is, let me know your thoughts down below. As well, if you are new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button as we're on the road to 400,000 subscribers, and we'll keep you to date with all things Cold War, Warzone, and Modern Warfare. So if you'd like to stay up to date with all things COD and join the community, I'd love to have you. That said, let's jump into it. Firstly, why is it important to discuss this with a little bit more urgency now, especially now updated than say beforehand? Well, I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't see another double-double event happening before season one. With season one's launch in just under 2 weeks time now at this point, I can't see them busting out another week or even weekend of upped yields for XP. So if it's like anything like Modern Warfare's post-launch support, we'll see a relatively untouched, out of the normal state of the game for the next week and a half or so, and then maybe some DLC teasers, maybe starting this week, but at least definitely starting as of next as well, leading up to DLC 1. Maybe with DLC 1 and Season 1, we could see an upped XP yield, maybe another double-double weekend, but for the time being, I just don't see it happening before December 10th here. But why is that important? Well, even if you don't care too much about Cold War's camos and ranking up the weapons to end up going for the challenges and unlocks associated with them, you want to make sure that you're ranked up in regards to the coming Warzone integration that will also be happening with Cold War's inaugural season. Granted, some of this has already started to happen with the operators and such. Cold War operators are currently in Warzone if you go over and check it out, but come Thursday, December 10th, every single weapon from Cold War is going to be playable in Warzone, but it will have the same properties as they did in Modern Warfare. The fact that they need to be ranked up in Cold War to utilize attachments for loadout drops and such. Now, that's important to note because unlike Modern Warfare, Cold War's attachments for weapons are honestly quite linear, meaning that the best attachments, objectively speaking, are always at the end of the weapon leveling grind. So you want to have those weapons ranked up as far as you can before jumping into it so you have the best opportunity to do well with those weapons. Now, honestly, how well these weapons will stack up against the Modern Warfare weapons existing already in Warzone, who knows? Maybe it's something where Cold War weapons just don't stand a chance against the already existing Warzone weaponry for Modern Warfare, or maybe vice versa. Maybe Cold War actually is head and shoulders above that weaponry, and there's some immediate mismatches in terms of weapon balance. But regardless, you want to have these weapons ranked up that you think you'll be using within Cold War. So do you need to rank up every weapon? Absolutely not. Truth be told, I'm only using this time personally as a way to rank up weapons I think will be really good, the rifles, SMGs, and also the weapons that I'm dreading in Cold War just for doing for camo challenges, such as the launchers and melees, which have a relatively tough time ranking up on standard XP. So those are my two key areas of focus. You could have different ones, you could have the same, but if you can't get all of them done throughout the past few days in the upcoming few to close out this event, at least focus on the bigger priority ones that can save you a lot of time now as opposed to later. But Warzone integration or camo grind aside, you want to rank these up, so the best ways to do that, I think right now, come down to four main areas of focus. Now, admittedly, there was a zombies bug, which was crazy, but truth be told, zombies XP is still pretty solid here and a great way to rank up. When double XP first kicked off here earlier in the week, it was acting as if it was actually quad XP or so in zombies, meaning that if you were able to grind out that first day in zombies, you absolutely maxed out a few weapons, at least a few. Now me, I was an absolute fool and didn't feel like grinding that night, just wasn't really having it, and I missed out on plenty of opportunity for ranking up weapons. But coming back to it, it's still actually pretty solid, and truthfully, this looks to get even better here because it's actually, according to the community manager at Treyarch, actually bugged right now to be giving less than intended XP yields. So while you can grind through, as you'll see here in a second, an insane amount of weapon levels in a very short period of time for just doing one simple farming task, it looks to get even better. But that said, I hop between this and Nuketown, but I'd say this is more enjoyable, even though it may be more monotonous and maybe a little bit more boring, just because there's no skill-based matchmaking to throw me into a full stack of MP5 wager players after I have a good match or two in Nuketown. This, I can just chill out, farm farm XP, maybe talk with my friends on Discord, and not really even have to pay too much attention to the gameplay itself, because again, it is rather straightforward, rather simple, and doesn't require a lot of hands-on focus. You can just take that time and turn it into XP for your weapons. Now, to do this, you want to farm through some of the lower rounds in a traditional zombies match. Me personally, I was going to round 7 or 8, then quitting out, because at that point, you can one-hit melee up until round 2, three-hit until round 4. 3 and then 4 is 3 hit, and then from there you can just simply rocket launcher them, where it's still 1 to 2 hit each time. So it's something that goes by really quickly, and you can rank up each weapon. In my case, I was doing launchers about 2 to 3 times in that short period of time, and that was only solo play. It changes drastically once you end up playing with more players. So if you want to play with randoms in a 4 stack, if you want to play solo, doesn't really matter, but you will get a little bit more XP out of playing with a lobby of 4. And that just comes down to simply more zombies spawning. But it's interesting because the way that weapon XP works in this game is that it tracks just like how EKIAs do whenever it comes to MP. If you end up putting even a little bit of damage into these zombies, you both get the full credit for the zombie's kill whenever that zombie is eliminated. So it works nearly identically to that EKIA system in multiplayer, so it's something that if you have a launcher, if you have something you can just do a little bit of damage and somebody else can finish them off, it's beneficial to all parties. Now, the interesting caveat here with this is that you'd think that that continues on into later rounds, right? Well, it seems like the more you end up pack-a-punching and modifying your weapons, it gives lower XP yields. So the only way that you can compete with the scaling health of zombies as you play higher and higher rounds is by pack-a-punching and modifying. So you inadvertently hurt that XP yield whenever you get to that point, meaning that earlier rounds are definitely going to be more beneficial because you can use those base weapons, you can get the most XP out of it, you can still get those easy kills, and so therefore those XP rates don't drop and you can take advantage of them fully. So if you want to play in a 4-man, I definitely recommend it. Go until round 7, round 8, back out, restart the entire process over. Again, is it necessarily anything hard? No, but you will rank up a lot here over that course of the monotonous 30 to 45 minutes, however long you want to play around with it. But definitely recommend that, and that's been my go-to as of the last couple of days here, just because it's easy XP and very laid back. It's just, for me personally, much more enjoyable than having to sweat every single game. The secondary go-to, I'm sure you can almost immediately guess, is the brand new introduction of Nuketown. Nuketown changed the entire dynamic of how you really want to play multiplayer, I think, because this is the only real map on offer right now that is constant engagements all of the time. There are some smaller maps that, yes, you can have higher kill games on. I know that it doesn't take too long to get from spawn to mid-map on, say, Moscow, Crossroads Strike, and maybe Armada Strike, and some stuff like that, but Nuketown is just always active when it comes to your engagements. So the two ways that I break this down, I've been playing a lot of hardcore, which I would definitely recommend, because it's great for all weapons. Again, if you're trying to get rid of those weapons and get them ranked up that are more annoying, maybe like the KSP, which is just not good in terms of the SMGs, if you want to use the pistols, if you want to use the launchers. Firstly, these are great for basically all of those weapons. You get more one-hit kill medals, which yields overall more XP as well, but it makes everything just about even in terms of gunfights. I can absolutely still range somebody with a pistol, even if they have an SMG or a rifle. Launchers, shotguns, SMGs, rifles, pistols, it's all equal playing ground because there is that lowered health and everything is about a 1-2 shot. So it's definitely nice that you can have that ability to compete with those weapons that you may otherwise not. Pacing again keeps it highly rewarding. More engagements, more kills, thus more weapon XP. So you're always in the action here with Nuketown, and it's definitely something that I would recommend playing because you can get in those games, jam pack a ton of XP into a small package of each individual match, jump out of the game and do it all over again within about a 2-minute span of probably lobby end to lobby start on a new one. Dirty Bomb is still great in terms of XP yields, but I've definitely gone more so towards Nuketown because it's not as beneficial when it comes down to individual timing. Unless you're dropping 30 to 40 to 50 kills every single game in Dirty Bomb, you're gonna just basically burn a lot of time trying to find players or maybe respawning because you may get ganged up on. But when it comes down to overall time frame and XP yields per smaller portion of time, I feel like Nuketown just edges out Dirty Bomb, even though there is that higher XP yield per kill when it comes to Dirty Bomb. But for multiplayer players, if you're interested in that kind of stuff, definitely play Nuketown and or Dirty Bomb again, depending on whichever one you feel more comfortable with, whatever you have more fun with. Everything else is still decent and dependent upon how many engagements you can come in contact with. But I think with Nuketown and Dirty Bomb, with those XP yields and the amount of engagements you'll see, They're just elevated above everything else in that traditional 6v6 and combined arms rotations of play. The final thing I want to talk about here is, again, that PlayStation bonus XP. This is something that naturally boosts if you're all on PlayStation, if I'm not mistaken, and playing together. This is something that boosts your XP yield for weapons by 25%, which is huge when you consider the ramifications of how long weapons take and how much of a grind it is over time. You definitely condense that time for each weapon greatly with 25%. I mean, if you've taken a time frame of an hour and you did exactly as well as somebody who ended up not being on PlayStation with a party, you'll save yourself 15 minutes right out of the gate. So it is something that over time adds up greatly. And of course, I'm quite jealous that there's not that on PC, because that is huge in terms of bonuses. But that's where we're gonna wrap it up. Just wanted to talk a little bit about some more updated processes to get the best weapon XP that you possibly can. And of course, take advantage of this while you still have the opportunity to. Of course, you still have these farming methods and such once double XP goes away, but being that it is doubled, you want to do it as much as possible, get in as much time, get in as much XP as you possibly can to rank up these weapons. And again, I truly don't see this happening again before Season 1 and the Warzone integration, so definitely very crucial right now. I wanted to talk to you guys about this and some of my updated thoughts. So hopefully you enjoyed the video. Hopefully this helps you out in some way, shape, or form. Let me know your thoughts down below. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you drop a like down below. And of course, if you are new to the channel, make sure you guys subscribe so you don't miss a single thing. We're getting all things Black Ops, Cold War, Warzone, and Modern Warfare. Anything COD related, we got you covered. If you guys also want to follow me over on Twitter and Instagram, there's the best places to get connected outside of YouTube. Probably live on both those. So if you guys want to strike up a conversation, ask me a question, whatever it may be, links in the description below. But let's end out of the way. Thank you guys all so much for watching. My name is Espresso. I'll see you guys later. Take care. And peace.